What's up, YouTube? I want to show you how to create text using AI and what the near future holds for AI text generation. Let's just say someone fixed the problem. For a long time now, it's been well documented that AI cannot create text. For some reason, no matter what you ask it for, it can't seem to spell or it just completely ignores what you ask it for. Stable Diffusion SDXL is probably the closest we've ever got to generating text, but even then, it still has its quirks and it never really fully gets you what you want. Even MidJourney still lacks the ability to create text, and that's the best we got. Well, come October, we'll see if MidJourney is still the best of the best because Dall-E 3 is coming out. I know, a lot of you are behind your monitors, giggling, lolling, or raffling. Like Dall-E, they haven't given MidJourney a run for its money since like last year, which was the very beginning of AI art. Can you believe it's only been about a year since MidJourney came out? Wow, AI time flies fast. Don't sleep on Dall-E 3 though, because this might actually be the quote unquote MidJourney killer that everybody memes about. There's actually a way to use Dall-E 3 right now for free, but it involves tricking the Bing Create site, so I won't go over that. But MadVidPro has a video on this topic and also his Discord thread has information on it. So if you want to use it now, yes you can. Anywho, let's face it, Dall-E shot themselves in the face with their complicated pricing strategies, nickel and diming you for every generation that you make. They doubled down from their fall from grace by that lackluster version 2, which was, I don't know what that was. It was disappointing to say the least. Then you combine that with the fact they gave 2.5 away by allowing you to create Dall-E version 2.5 images for free with Bing Chat. Wait, you didn't know you can create images with Bing Chat? Try it out. Ask Bing Chat to create an image and then describe the image, and I'll use Dall-E 2.5 to make that image. I have a video in my description if you want to learn more about that. Anyways, it's important to note that MidJourney is the best that we got. It's the greatest of all time for AI art, but it can't create text. And text is super useful if you're trying to do something other than say, hey, that's a cool image. I can't stress how important creating text is for making stuff, whether you're making a flyer for a party, memes, a t-shirt, or maybe even a coffee cup that says your morning copium with your favorite MMORPG that nobody plays anymore. Having the power to create text is the key to success when selling your artwork. Let's see MidJourney do all that. I'm sure that comment's not gonna age well with how fast AI art's moving. Dall-E 3, on the other hand, can create amazing text and chat bubbles and an entire comic book. Check out these examples. That brings me to my next point, which is it can understand natural language much better since it uses that paid version of ChatGPT. And you don't have to be a prompt engineer to recreate the Mona Lisa. It also creates stunning art and it can understand your gibberish because it's combined with the latest ChatGPT technology, which is amazing. Did someone say paid version? Although it's amazing, it's not free. There, I said it. You'll have to pay $20 for OpenAI's premium services. So in a nutshell, ChatGPT Plus and Enterprise members will have access to Dall-E. Well, you're probably thinking, what's the free alternative that can generate text? Well, let me introduce you to the solution, and it's a completely free solution right now. Let me introduce you to Ideogram.ai. Remember those words, because everyone from Etsy, Wirestock, and Creative Fabrica are going to flood this site. This has to be the most useful AI tool in terms of making stuff. Things like mugs, t-shirts, and my personal favorite, memes. It's actually absolutely useful and more so than MidJourney. And it's free. Don't get me wrong, nobody comes close to MidJourney, but take a look at my happy birthday message to my buddy here. A+ on the artwork there, MidJourney, but you can't spell. Now let's try that with Ideogram. Yup. That's exactly what I wanted. And you usually get it within the first try. You can spell an entire sentence in one try. Pretty amazing to go from can't spell anything with AI art to spelling entire phrases. You also have the ability to build a picture and then change things about it. Usually it changes everything but the text. So it has a variation button and a bunch of other cool features. And it's very simple to use. So let's take a look at what this tool is capable of. Simply by scrolling through the community website, you can tell how accurate this thing is with all the phrases people have here and strung together. The image creation itself isn't as good as the big boys, but it's the worst it'll ever be. And it's all up from here, right? By that meaning they just released it. So probably in a month, 2 months, it's going to look a lot better. So the capability is absolutely there, but they're just going to have to adjust some weights and parameters. Just a couple weeks ago, people couldn't do any of this. People couldn't create any text at all with any AI art. Aside from SDXL, but it wasn't like first try with SDXL, you get exactly what you want. And I created a bunch of these with the first or second try. Ideogram didn't even break a sweat. I asked it to make super long words like subscribe to artificially intelligent, and it did it perfectly. Oh, and by the way, if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Anyways, try making a 4-letter word in MidJourney. You couldn't even do that. MidJourney's ADD will kick in and it'll do something completely different. I mean, it'll look amazing, I'll give it that, but it's not gonna be what you asked for. So how do you get access to this tool right now? Well, like any tool that I show you, just go to my video description and it'll be there. Hi there. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. And if you like this kind of content, you want to see some more cool AI stuff, go ahead and subscribe. By the way, if you didn't know, you can create an animation just like this in seconds using Adobe Express, and it's absolutely free. Just go to Adobe Express, look for Animate from Audio, and then just click record, and then everything will be done for you. Yep. So yeah, like and subscribe. Thanks. Now let's talk about how to generate stuff with this tool. Basically, you just describe what you want to see and click generate. Yep, it's that easy. This has to be one of the more simplified tools out there with AI art, because it's just kind of you create it and they'll even give you some like kind of suggestions, but really it's just a prompt and click generate. So it seems like this is definitely made with the mainstream audience in mind. It doesn't have your fancy control net stuff, but it gets the job done. Now you don't have to do this, but I like putting quotes around anything that I have like a phrase of or words that I want to end up on a picture. You can even choose different options here like poster or cinematic, and they have a bunch to choose from, which will really change your picture. Another thing you can do if you don't like the picture, you can totally just remove the background on some of the words and just create the words with a blank background. All right, so let's try one out. And as you can see, you start typing inside it, some suggestions pop up and you can click on one and add it to your prompt. And if you click see all here, you'll see all the different choices you get. And there's even a lucky style, which is pretty cool. It'll just give you something random. You also have three dimensions to choose from. You got your 10x16, which is your portrait sizes. You got your 1x1, which is the normal square, and then you got your 16x10, which is your widescreen, aka landscape. So you got the taller than wide, evenly squared, and wider than tall. First one we're gonna do is a t-shirt logo. So t-shirt logos, you want to just make the background blank and then put some phrase here, put it in quotes, and voila, there you go. Now I want to make a cup design for morning copium. For this one, it's going to be kind of hard, so I'm just going to create the text based on a picture, and then I'll make the picture. And then I'll combine it with the picture using a free tool here, which is like Photoshop, but it's called Photopea. If you didn't know, you can actually put this in Stable Diffusion, which I have a tutorial on that. But you can just go to their website as well, which is what I'm doing right now. By the way, I'll leave that link in the description for Photopea or Photopea, however you want to call it. But yeah, it's a free Photoshop tool with ads. No sign up or login necessary, but you can do things like remove background and also some advanced editing and layering. I left two tutorials as well, how to put that into Stable Diffusion, and you can also just use the information in there. But it also shows you some methods on how you can use that tool to improve your art. Just real quickly, here's an image of Putin and Kim on a horse. Oh, it's one of my favorites. So it does generate some funny looking art. Now let's put this tool to the test. I created a few designs and I'm gonna put them on some products for drop shipping. Then I'll show you how easy it could be done using Printful. Now I'm not sponsored by Printful, nor am I sponsored by anyone on my small channel, but it's definitely one of the places you can go to sell your stuff. But here's the first use case. So I'm on Printful right now, and here you can do some print on demand stuff. Now they take a large amount of your profit, like a huge amount, depending on how much you're gonna sell your shirt, but what do you care, because you're not paying for the store, you're not moving it around the warehouse, you're not handling the logistics from end to end for the purchase, shipping and receiving of the product, not to mention their infrastructure to handle payments, as well as the amount of money they invested in tools and where they went to get a buyer to make these shirts. A lot goes into it, so if they're taking most of the money, I mean, they deserve it, right? But you can always create the shirts at home, and Amazon, they have like shirt printers and stuff like that, but that's I don't got time for that. So I'm just gonna put on this shirt and try to make a dollar. So all we're really doing is uploading our design to this t-shirt, then telling them where to sell it and how much we want to sell it for. Well, that part gets a lot more complicated and needs a video on its own, but honestly, we live in the age of AI, so you can just open up Bing chat like this and ask how I can sell my shirt from Printful and where I can sell it. Is that hard? I made it sound super easy, so it's not going to take like a minute to do, but it's going to give you all the steps that you need to either sell this on Etsy, on Amazon, and how to connect your account. So it gives you everything that you need to know. Like I said, that deserves its own video. So maybe in the future, that's something I do. Now here's another use case for it. And we have this comic book generator. It's a pretty amazing free tool. And what this tool does is basically a website you can just go on now. And the link will be in my video description. And you can actually just go there and then type something out and it'll create a complete story for you. It's gonna use ChatGPT to create the story of what you asked for. It's gonna create all the different comic book scenes, and you just have to choose the layout. Pretty amazing. One thing it doesn't do well is text inside the text bubble. So if you get a text bubble, you can always do two things. You can either create text using a ideogram, which I don't get the bubbles, so normally I would actually create the bubble using ideogram, but you can always download a text like this right here. And this is the typical comic book style text. In fact, it's the one on the loading screen on this site, and it's an easy install right there. It's installed. So now you'll have that as an option when you look at your text editors. You could even do it in Word or in PowerPoint. You'll have that new font. Kind of cool, right? This font type also has chat bubbles if you want to use that to create pictures. A little bit cumbersome. I'd rather just make them in Ideogram. It's easier for me. But yeah, check it out. We got a comic book there. And we've created words for inside the text. Alrighty, so I think you got the gist of it. Ideogram is an amazing tool to create amazing text art, typography, memes, shirts, products, logos, and much more. Something that would normally take you hours to create and a lot of skill and creativity can now be done in seconds. I know some people are mad at that statement, but it's just what's happening. I'm just reporting the news, don't shoot the messenger. But this is a pretty significant milestone in AI art history. Between Ideogram and Dall-E 3, and I hope to see this in more tools in the future. Now the sky's the limit. We can create logos, party invitations, custom t-shirts, cups. Hell, we can make happy birthday card like I did for my friend, having this guy hold it for them. Pretty cool, right? This is like just the beginning of Ideogram. This is a free tool and they're already on top of their game. They're like ahead of everybody else. Maybe Dall-E 3 will beat them, but really, that is to be seen. Plus, Dall-E 3 isn't free. So this is that MidJourney moment where you see the trajectory of greatness for a product and people starting to like it and figure out how amazing it is. But yep, this tool is destined for greatness and we're gonna see a lot from this company and this tool. But if you want to learn more about AI before it enslaves us and turns us into batteries, definitely subscribe to the channel so you can learn more about it. And if you like the video, definitely give it a thumbs up. But something you should definitely do is have a great day and take it easy. Bye.